Hello, everyone. Welcome again to my virtual home. Now, today I wanted to come on and do an updated video to my NexRep video. You can consider this to be like a NexRep review part two, or just additional information about the NexRep opportunity and how to stay on contract with NexRep. So let's get right into it, guys. This will be somewhat of a short video. Now, staying on contract with NexRep is very important. NexRep is an opportunity that really doesn't discriminate beyond a background check. As long as you can pass that background check, then you can consider yourself hired with NexRep. Now, how to stay on contract is a whole totally different story. Now, as you're doing your research, you might come up on things like how NexRep terminates people's contracts without notice. And I have to say, that is true. So you have to do your research and determine whether or not this position is right for you. So I want to help you with that. So with NexRep, let's talk about the schedule. Now the scheduling with the NexRep is pretty cool because you can schedule yourself in a 30-minute increment, 24 hours a day. Therefore, you can work late nights, early mornings, midday, what have you. It's totally up to you. That is a benefit that NexRep has. So thumbs up to NexRep for that. When you're scheduling yourself, now NexRep allows you to schedule yourself, but they want you to adhere to the schedule that you set. Therefore, they have a percentage. They want most of their agents to stay within 90% of everything that they schedule. For themselves. So stay within 90% of your scheduled working hours. As any job that is not too much to ask. But people who do not do that put themselves at risk of getting their contract terminated or not renewed with NexRep. With that being said, you definitely want to stay within 90% of what you committed to on your schedule, and definitely don't drop below 70%. When you drop below 70% of a commit budget, and that is something that you're constantly doing, that is a red flag for NexRep. Again, communication is very important. If something is going on, instead of just not showing up for your committed shifts and not saying anything, you might want to communicate those things to someone at NexRep so they know exactly what's going on. So let's talk about the contract. Now, NexRep hires agents and contracts agents to work in 6-month increments. So therefore, there are 2 contract renewals throughout the year. One of them, I believe, is in June. The other is in December. So if you were hired, let's just say, after December, well, your contract review for renewal will come up in June. And if you were hired after June, your contract renewal think it's going to come up in December. So that's where they're going to look at your performance and look at everything and determine whether or not you're somebody or an agent that they want to retain. With that being said, let's talk about the schedule rollout. With NexRep, the schedule rolls out one time a week. The day of the week is Tuesday, 7 p.m. The schedule will roll out early for those agents who are considered to be elite agents who are, you know, doing well with the role. Their schedule will roll out like around 4:30 p.m. on that Tuesday. Schedule rollout is very important. You kind of want to be already logged in front of your computer on the website when the schedule rolls out, or you will risk the not getting all the hours you want or having to log in a few hours before you want to actually work and kind of stop the schedule for people to let go of commits that you can then claim. So if you're not there when the schedule rolls out, then you kind of just have to get the hours as they come and kind of work it on a, you know, hours showed up, I'll take it type of basis. Another good thing to discuss with the NexRep is call flow. Now, with NexRep, they have hourly positions, and they also have positions where they pay based off of talk time. So call flow is going to be very important, because if you're not getting calls, in some instances and on some contracts, you won't be making money. So now, for instance, with NexRep, they have an as seen on TV campaign where customers are calling in because of an infomercial that they've seen on TV. And these customers are very easy to convert because they already want the product based off of something that they've seen on TV. So therefore, your job is just to collect their basic information, their name, their card number, give them exactly what they want. Now, if you're doing this and you're doing it consistently, NexRep will send you more calls. So that's what they mean by call flow. Call flow is based on performance. So the more you're selling, the more happy customers, the more calls you get. Now, everybody that starts is going to start with a very low call flow. So don't expect to make a whole lot of money that first week, because your call flow is kind of like evaluating your performance, but then it can pick up very quickly. So that's great, guys. Call flow, like I say, is by performance. Now, earnings, NexRep pays twice a month, bi-weekly. So every 2 weeks, you'll be receiving a paycheck with NexRep. They do pay pretty consistently. They pay direct deposit. So you want to have your bank account kind of set up and ready to go with them. You're paid as an independent contractor, not an employee. So therefore, you receive all of your pay and you're responsible for taking out all of your taxes. Now, like I said, NexRep is a great opportunity, but you do have to be on top of it to basically protect your contract, mainly by showing up when you say you're going to show up, not missing out on those commits. If you sign up for that 30-minute block, make sure that you're going to take that 30-minute block. Outside of that, you want to be closing these customers when they call. They already know what they want. So, you know, you just kind of find your balance and give them what they want. Now, you are reading from scripts with NexRep, but they give you flexibility. There are certain areas that you have to read verbatimly, and then there are other areas where you can just, you know, do your own thing. And if it's working, keep working at it. And if it's not working, you can switch it up. But yeah, you want to protect your contract by being there when you say you're going to be there. Also, closing the customers. Secondly, NexRep has expectations on certain key products where they want you to have a certain gross sales on certain products. So you do want to keep a lookout. If you receive a call on the key products, you want to do your very best there so that you can meet that gross sale initiative. They also have different incentives that rolls out that's going to allow you to make more money throughout your week. So you want to keep an eye on that. Overall, NexRep is a great opportunity for those who can be on and be on top of it. Now, if you got a lot of things going on, your environment is not conducive to working from home, it's not a quiet environment or things like that, then this may not be the opportunity for you. But if you can commit to your schedule, you can work hard, work a little bit harder on those key products, this position is a slam dunk for you. So I am here again, and I'm happy to have provided this NexRep review part 2. If you guys have any other questions, what I want you to do is just comment them below. If you have any experience with NexRep, if you've been with NexRep, whether you're currently with them or you got terminated or left for any reason, let us know about your experience below. We definitely want to discuss it with you. Also, if you just kind of came on my video, you just kind of found me, and you want to get to know me a little bit more, you want to see some different content from me, comment that below. Also, like this video and subscribe to my network. And you guys, thank you for watching my virtual home, and you have an awesome day. Bye-bye.